Good evening. This is TV7 Israel News, broadcasting to you from Jerusalem. And in today's top stories, after a Jewish cemetery was found desecrated in eastern France, Israel has urged the leadership of Paris in particular and Europe in general to take a strong stand against anti-Semitism. Following three separate bilateral meetings, Prime Minister Bibi Netanyahu hailed Israel's growing relations with Slovakia, the Czech Republic, and Hungary, all of whom have taken steps to elevate their diplomatic presence in Jerusalem. Britain has signed a trade continuity agreement with Israel ahead of the anticipated withdrawal of the United Kingdom from the European Union. Poland's decision to pull out from a summit of the Visegrad Group plus Israel after a diplomatic dispute emerged over Israeli accusations of Polish complicity with Nazi Germany during the Holocaust has forced Prime Minister Bibi Netanyahu to alter his schedule and hold three separate bilateral meetings with his visiting counterparts from Slovakia, the Czech Republic, and Hungary. The three Central European leaders have arrived in Jerusalem for the planned Israeli-hosted summit prior to the Polish decision. While all three leaders underscored their warm relations with the Jewish state, they also alluded to their frustration over the canceling of the summit and urged Warsaw and Jerusalem to resolve their diplomatic dispute. Poland withdrew from the summit after Israel's acting foreign minister Israel Katz said earlier this week that many Poles had collaborated with the Nazis in World War II and shared responsibility for the Holocaust. While this topic triggered a sensitive issue on which both countries vehemently disagree, the Prime Minister of the Czech Republic said that it would not damage the important cooperation between Poland and Israel.
Let's say situation, and I'm sure that Poland and Israel will continue in cooperation and will solve this problem soon.
Meanwhile, Slovakian Prime Minister Peter Pellegrini announced in a joint press conference alongside his Israeli counterpart Benjamin Netanyahu that the important Visegrad plus Israel summit would be rescheduled to the second half of 2019, which will take place in Slovakia.
Second half of this year, we can organize a really great visit of an Israeli Prime Minister to Slovakia together with the business delegation, and I hope this will strengthen our relationships, which are really now on a very good and very friendly level.
After the three separate meetings concluded, Prime Minister Bibi Netanyahu released a film statement in which he refrained from talking about the crisis with Poland. Instead, the Israeli leader hailed Israel's growing relations with Slovakia, the Czech Republic, and Hungary, all of whom have taken steps to elevate their diplomatic presence in Jerusalem.
After months of efforts that I have led, we have a very important achievement. Hungary decided to open a diplomatic mission of its embassy in Jerusalem. סלובקיה החליטה לפתוח מרכז חדשנות ותרבות בירושלים. וזה אחרי שצ'כיה הכריזה על פתיחת בית צ'כיה בירושלים. אלה מאמצים שנושאים פרי.
While TV7 has yet again requested a comment from the Israeli Foreign Ministry in Jerusalem about the course of intended action vis-à-vis the crisis with Poland, after Warsaw demanded an official apology, the foreign ministry's spokesman said that Jerusalem has no response on the matter as of yet. Now in other news, Prime Minister Bibi Netanyahu released a statement in which he urged the leadership of Paris in particular, and Europe in general, to take a strong stand against anti-Semitism that after a Jewish cemetery was found desecrated in eastern France.
80 קברים יהודים חוללו בסמלי נאצים על ידי אנטישמים פרועים. אני קורא לכל מנהיגי צרפת ואירופה לצאת בתקיפות נגד האנטישמיות. זו מגפה שמסכנת את כולם, לא רק אותנו, ויש לגנות אותה בכל מקום ובכל פעם שהיא מרימה את ראשה.
Swastikas and inscriptions were found on some 80 graves of the Jewish cemetery of Kwatzenheim, a village of 800 inhabitants that is situated close to the city of Strasbourg. In response to the heinous act, French President Emmanuel Macron stressed in a joint press conference in Paris with his visiting Georgian counterpart that any attack against the Jewish community in France, it is the whole republic that is targeted.
Mais je veux ici redire qu'à chaque fois qu'un Français, parce qu'il est juif, est insulté, menacé, ou pire, blessé ou tué, c'est la République tout entière qui l'est. Et il n'appartient pas aux Juifs dans la République de se défendre, mais à la République de les défendre.
When asked about the fact that anti-Semitism is directly linked to anti-Zionism and whether the French government would act to criminalize the latter, President Macron carefully noted that while the two hate-based sentiments are linked, legally setting them on the same level may pose other problems.
Sur l'antisionisme, je l'ai dit sans ambiguïté, je ne pense pas que pénaliser l'antisionisme soit une bonne solution. Je reviendrai plus précisément demain sur ces sujets. Mais je confirme que ceux qui aujourd'hui, dans le discours, veulent la disparition d'Israël sont ceux qui veulent s'attaquer aux Juifs. Je pense néanmoins que, lorsqu'on rentre dans le détail, la condamnation pénale de l'antisionisme pose d'autres problèmes.
It is important to note that the grave desecration in Kwatzenheim was perpetrated by unknown assailants just 2 months after another Jewish cemetery was desecrated in Herlesheim. Among other attacks in recent days that were classified by French police as motivated by anti-Semitism. In response to the spike in such attacks across the country, thousands of people rallied in Paris last night to protest a growing phenomenon against the Jews in France, which houses the biggest Jewish community in Europe and the third largest in the world. Politicians from across the spectrum also joined the marches against anti-Semitism, including two former French presidents, François Hollande and Nicolas Sarkozy. Now back to Israel, where British International Trade Secretary Liam Fox has signed a trade continuity agreement with Israel ahead of the anticipated withdrawal of the United Kingdom from the European Union. After the signing ceremony, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu spoke by telephone with the British Trade Minister, during which Netanyahu congratulated Fox on the agreement that is viewed by Israel with great importance. The Israeli Prime Minister added that Great Britain is an important friend of Israel and noted that the agreement reflected that. It is important to note that Britain is Israel's largest European trade partner and third largest trading partner overall. In 2018, the trade turnover between the two countries amounted to about $11 billion. Meanwhile, just several hours after the signing ceremony in Israel, Secretary Liam Fox traveled to the West Bank city of Ramallah, where he signed another trade continuity agreement with the Palestinian Authority. Well, British Trade Secretary admitted in his statement that the agreement with the Palestinians did not bear significant economic value, he stressed that the symbolic element clearly showed London's commitment to the Palestinian cause.
Taking the time, and to you and all your officials for putting in the hard work to get this agreement signed. It's very important for us, provides us with continuity as we leave the European Union, but even more important than its economic element is the symbolic element that it shows our commitment.
While the United Kingdom continues to support Palestinian aspirations for statehood with East Jerusalem as its capital, the Palestinian relations with the United States continue to deteriorate. After a decision was announced several months ago by U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on Washington's intention to merge all U.S. missions in Jerusalem, reports quoting administration officials claim that the anticipated move will happen as early as the 4th of March. According to the report, the United States Consulate in Jerusalem, which serves both Israelis and Palestinians, will be absorbed into the new U.S. Embassy to Israel, an anticipated move that has been condemned by the Palestinian leadership. According to the Palestinian presidential spokesman, Nabil Abu Rodeyna, contacts at the political level with the American administration have been cut off and will remain so unless the American administration changes its position on both Jerusalem and the refugees. That said, neither the U.S. State Department nor the Israeli Foreign Ministry agreed to respond to TV7's request for comment on the report. Thank you for watching us. Praying for the peace of Israel and the peace of Jerusalem. I'm Jonathan Hassan. Have a Erev Tov, and we will see you again tomorrow at the same time.